Thank you. Wow, what a thing to follow. Holy cow, welcome Vancouver to CannaFest 2014. I'm honored to be here and to speak about the Coalition Against Repeal and some of the work we've been doing since 2012. Our booth is right over there, and we have National Reps Bob and Jen Bennett in the house that are able to inform people further. Some of the work we've done, in essence, the government in 2012 came out and said that myself, my friends, and of course many people in this room chose to collect mold, start fires, and that we're all gangsters. And Mr. Conroy, $70,000 later, you know, after a lot of fundraising in 2013, slapped a restraining order on the federal government on March 21st, 2014. And of course, that has saved 36,000 patients of the 40,000 who had permits in this country who chose to grow medical marijuana. Now, the problem that I had was the fire, the mold, and the gangsters. Once again, it was proved to be anecdotal at best. So the government lied, the red herring. Then there was a great promise. We got the LPs. Heaven forbid, we got the LPs. So a lot of my friends are in that thousand waiting to get their licensed producer application processed. Only 21 are out there. They're public stock trading companies. They're people that are posturing to be in 7-Eleven. Everybody talks about let's legalize. Hell yeah, let's legalize. They're gonna do it. Not for we the people, not for my work. Mr. Emery's in the house, he's done many years of work. They're not gonna legalize for that. They see the money. They see the money in Colorado. They see what's going on in Alaska. Oregon just legalized as well. It's only in Washington State where they screwed up. They legalized and said, but you can't grow. You're natural, but you can't grow. So you have to ask yourself here in Canada, as we usher in this new generation of legalization, do we want a country where we can go to 7-Eleven and buy a sole proprietor, 21 company set up as they have now with the MMPR, and not be allowed to grow the plant and explore the different genetics that we're able to grow? I mean, it's a common sense answer. When we look at Colorado and we look at the peace, there's no fire, there's no mold, there's no gangsters. The only problem they have is they don't have enough supply. I often reference, you know, the fact that we've had so many 420s, so many gatherings and cannabis days, no violence. We don't have any of those problems. We've had all these events and fundraisers from coast to coast to do all this to take on the government. Once again, it costs us $70,000. And when I say restrain the federal government, it's a fancy word for an injunction. That's what Mr. Conroy put on the government. Very hard to do. Now, we got them set for trial. Now, the crown's splitting hairs. They want to say, we're going to appeal. The patients never proved they're going to suffer irreparable harm. I'm like, really? 500,000 patients in this country are estimated to use medical marijuana. And they're not suffering right now when only 10,000 are accessing the medical marijuana or marijuana for medical purposes program. Well, 36,000 are protected under injunction. Now, the reason we have a cross appeal, now I know that sounds funny because first it's strange to have an appeal and an injunction because of course we're going to trial just next year in February, but the Crown wants to split hairs. So they appealed, we also appealed. We felt the judge erred. The judge's job is not to regulate the law or to legislate, simply to order the government what's just and suggest to them to write a law that is, of course, constitutional. This is what we're asking. So as we move on forward now, the Crown is saying, we haven't proved irreparable harm, or we haven't proved irreparable harm would befall patients, and that Justice Manson failed in that regard. And we're saying the judge shouldn't have legislated the 150 gram restrictive limit on patients. The oversight on the address change. Patients can't change their address. Patients move for a host of reasons. This is gonna go on from 2012. On our shirts, they say 2016. You can see it on Bob's shirt over here. That's because that's when we predict this is gonna end. I'd like to say it's gonna fully end there, but it's not. Now, our cross appeal is also about the dates. In the appeal, it gives two dates. March 21st, the day it was signed by the judge, and of course, it gives the September 30th date when people could no longer apply for their medical licenses. Now, the government knows that this made a lot of people fall outside the injunction. So myself, I filed 174 statements that I collected from various patients across the country, and it breaks my heart to read it. Some people were in the process of selling their homes. Then they fall outside injunctive protection. You know, there's a lot of patients that are suffering right now as a direct result of the conservative government's policy who we need to remove. We need to look at who's going to be in the government. And of course, you're gonna hear like you've already heard decriminalized from the conservatives of all people, in brief. Then they come out with their attack ads. So we have to look at, again, if legalization comes next year in our elections, or whether it comes after the 2016 US elections, we have to seriously take a look at what's going on in this country. There is only 21 licensed producers serving 10,000 patients, and it's a sole proprietor, large corporation. You need about $50 million to get in. A lot of people are getting screwed in this country. It started with the patients, started with the red herring, fire, mold, gangsters. We restrained them on that issue and proved it to be false. They also changed the language that there was only gonna be 51 licensed producers in fiscal years 1 and 2 of the MMPR. I told everybody this in 2012. A lot of people got mad at me because they were gonna make a lot of money in the green rush. Well, Shoppers Drug Mart and others in public stock trading companies, they're making tons of money on paper. They're the ones who are gonna be selling Molson Cannabis and Labatt's Cannabis to you in 7-Eleven in 5 years. That's my prediction. Now, for the medical patients of this country who no longer need to suffer, we need to understand that we've demonstrated what a coalition of medical patients, a ragtag group, can raise $200,000, restrain the federal government of Canada, and sue them for $40 million for breaching our privacy as a collective effort of 8,000 patients. Now, what can we do if us, the cannabis culture, because now it's our clubs, trust me, the facilitators of this event are under the very same attack that myself and my friends are with this federal legislation. They are opening up clinics. I point to St. Catharines. Take a look, St. Catharines, Ontario, there's a clinic. It's open, you go in, you sign up, you see a nurse practitioner or a doctor, they sign you up, you get your LP, you go back the next day and you get your delivery. And it's all legal, it's a loophole in the system. That's what's coming to BC next, and that's what's going to be shutting our clubs down as they try to usher in their version of legalization after 70 freaking years of lies to us. Lies, lies, and lies. Just like the fire, mold, and the gangsters. So friends, as the patients continue to usher this in, we know we're going to win our constitutional right to our gardens. That ain't going to go nowhere. The problem is that the government's going to write out what reasonable access to it is. Therefore, myself, the Cannabis in Canada Society, I implore anybody to go to cannabisincanada.ca, check out the work that we're doing, because we're keeping our eye on Big Brother and what they're doing, because this is much bigger than the medical patients. We're going to win our fight, but this is about all of us. This is about our culture. We need to unite, fight, and stand down this sole proprietor takeover so that Canada can have a true, free, and fair market. On that note, this is one love, one plan. Everybody have a great night and rock and roll. Peace.
Just a Wilcox.